All right. All right, put this in the fridge. A toast to you guys for me making a lot, having a lot of subscribers, nearly made to my goal. I got 3.69k subscribers. Thank you guys, you're the best. Cheers. Let me charge my phone for a bit. Got a portable charger. Let's get started. Yeah, Lambo Rock Strikes Back. Get Lambo Rock Strikes Back. Okay, who the fuck is here? Oh well. Get Lambo Rock Strikes Back. Shut the fuck up! Get Lambo Rock Strikes Back. Okay. Get Lambo Rock Strikes Back. Oh god, not you fucking zombie wankers. Oh god. Okay. My turn. Get inside of fan 2001 known as the Troll 3 Jerk Lord. Get inside of fan 2001 known as the Troll 3 Jerk Lord. Get inside of fan 2001 known as the Troll 3 Jerk Lord. Get inside of fan 2001 known as the Troll 3 Jerk Lord. Better. Well, guys, I've rewatched this abomination film. The movie that ruined the Sweet Light Zack and Cody franchise, and a underwhelming way to close a great series. This is how you fucking repay me. Now I'm gonna do a redo rant on the worst Disney Channel original movie I've ever seen in my life, the second most disappointing movie I've ever seen in my life, the second worst movie of 2011, and also the worst Disney Channel original movie I've ever seen in my 26 years of my life, period. Let's start the rant. Oh. 12 years later, and I still despise this movie. You would need 10 glasses of water to get through this movie. I'm wanting to know, I'm drinking water right now, sparkly water. Hey guys, it's Lambo Rock Strikes Back once again. And good morning in the UK, it is now 8:53 in my country, so I still got time to do a rant before I go to work. So yay, I'm gonna do a rant on the Sweet Life movie. It's the best Disney Channel original movie I've ever seen. I cannot wait to rant on it. It's gonna be so exciting. No, it's not. It's not a review. This is a rant. And the last rant I told previously on Lambo Rock Strikes Back rant series, Star Wars Evil Cleed, an absolute disgrace to the Star Wars Evil TV show, and an underwhelming way to close a great show. So I'm going to rant on, a redo rant on the Sweet Life movie, came out in 2011, the same year as The Smurfs, Cars 2, Rio, Rango, The Adventures of Tintin, or The Adventures of Tintin, The Secret of the Unicorn, which is called in my country, not confused with the Adventures of Tintin Secret Unicorn comic book. It came out the same year as all those films. So now let's get into the plot. So base the plot is, if this movie does have a fucking plot taking place, I'm guessing after the TV show left off, or take place after before the graduation episode, which is the series finale of the Suite Life on Deck series. We have Cody is going to is invited to go to Dr. Olson's internship, and they invite Zach and Cody to come there, and also of course there is, I think it's either wait a second guys. So it starts nicely in the ship, and they're doing some stuff, and Zach was trying to tell about Bailey's feelings, not Bailey from Hamstone Gretel, Bailey in this series, in this one, which he was in the TV show, which I did some research before I make this rhyme, because I haven't seen the show for years. And the invite to the internship went really well, and then later Professor Olson turned out to be the villain. They went to this camp thing, and then Cody got fired from the internship, and they come back, and then it is up to them to defeat Professor Doctor Olson and save the day, and that's basically what the plot is. Now you guys thinking, Lambo, you did a rant on this movie back in 2018. That was the very first rant you did on the channel. Yes, I did, and yeah, that rant was bogus. That rant was pretty shit. Honestly, I'm still keeping the video for fun memories. That's my very first rant on my channel. But let me tell you guys a story. This is back when Disney Channel was off the map. They were like the bomb. They were amazing back in the day. I remember I was browsing through YouTube. I was watching this promo for what's coming in 2011, which unfortunately that video I mentioned got taken down. If I ever find that video, I will be more happy to post on the community tab. That'd be my first discovery, and I found out that this Suite Life is getting a movie. When I heard they're getting a movie, I was like, oh, nice, they're making a movie? Sign me in. And as for TV show itself, the original show is an absolute amazing series. It was a huge part of my childhood. Suite on Deck may not be as good as the original, but it's still a good series. And definitely part of my childhood. And I heard them making the movie, and I was like, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I'm seeing what they're going to bring next to the table. And I remember seeing an ad for it. I was like, yes, I'm looking forward to this. And I didn't watch this movie until 2012, because the movie aired in my country in 2012. So I remember, I was like, yes, I'm looking forward to watch it. I recorded, I was like, this is going to be a great movie. But I was wrong. So the first day came, the day came in March. I watched it the day it came out after school. So I sat down, watched the Suite Life movie on Disney Channel. And after watching it, I didn't like it. That's right. I didn't like this movie. I was majorly disappointed with this movie. But on rewatch 12 years later, I got a confession to say, guys. But I still don't like this movie. As a matter of fact, I absolutely hate this movie. This movie really broke my heart. And this is literally way before Nickelodeon betrayed me with Loud House Season 5. And way before Sony Pictures Animation betrayed me with Hotel Transylvania Transformania. This is the first time I really got betrayed after watching this movie. So anyway, guys, before I tell this movie to pop, do I have any good things about this movie?
Let me think. No.
Honestly, I have nothing. I have nothing good about this movie. Now let's get into the negatives. Now let's get into the story. The story. Oh my god. The story of this movie is a fucking mess. It is a freaking mess. I mean, it doesn't really feel like a Suite Life movie. This literally feels like it's been taken from an episode of Lab Rats. That's how I can summarize it. It basically just feels like a pilot to an episode of Lab Rats, which is the Disney XD sitcom, which That was a good series. That was part of my childhood. I used to watch that quite a lot back on Disney XD. And now let's get into the voice acting. Now the voice acting in the shows were great, but the voice acting in this one, it's not good at all. And let's get into characters. Like, I mean, Zack in this movie, he was a dumbass in this movie. Like, seriously. And even Cody was an idiot in this movie. Sorry, guys, there's no occasion. Back, I was saying, guys. And even either one of them did the window fish thing. Look at the fish in the window. And he did a reference to Friends. Now, even though I never seen episode of Friends, but he did the... I did see this clip on YouTube Shorts. He was doing the Joey... He's doing a reference to his Friends where Joey says, "Hey, how are you doing?" Yes, he even did... He's in the window. He was like, say the fish, "Hey, how are you doing?" What the fuck? The kids won't understand the reference. That is... What the fuck? That is just messed up. That is absolutely just messed up. That is just a stupid joke in this movie. And now let's get into London and Mosey. They're completely wasted in this movie. They didn't do nothing but jack shit in this movie. And speaking of Mosey, let's get into him. He's my favorite character in both TV shows. But honestly, he was an idiot in this movie. He was an idiot in this movie. Oh yeah, this movie takes place during the spring break. It takes place during the spring break, and also let's get into London is an idiot in this movie, and there's even a scene where when either Zack was trying to call Barely, and they just ignore him. What the fuck? This movie was also kind of mean spirit. This movie was kind of mean spirit. And let's get into let's get into the submarine scene, which is the scene where Zack and Cody goes in the submarine. Oh my god, this scene was so boring. I was watching on my laptop last night on Disney Plus, and honestly, it just didn't work. It's just a snore fest. But we'll get to the worst scene later in this movie. Now let's get into... And we have the villain, Dr. Oswald, whatever his name is the main antagonist of this movie. He's by far one of the worst characters of this movie. His plans are so stupid, so predictable, and his motivation is absolutely dumb. I'll be honest, he starts a nice guy at first, but then later of his true color, he turned to be the villain in this movie. A twist villain. And there's even a scene. There's actually a twist villain. There's actually a clone of him. Pull his mask out. And review it to be a twin brother. What the fuck? Absolute what the fuck? This is an absolute pointless twist I've ever seen in this movie. Spider-Man Into Spider-Verse had a better twist villain of the Prowler. Better than that one. Honestly, I didn't have a reaction when I first watched that scene, but on rewatch, dear God. Honestly, this move really broke my heart. And there's even a scene with the invention of the villain news, and he has Zack and Cody fighting in this some kind of Doctor Strange style. And I said to myself, okay, this scene literally copied Doctor Strange, even though that movie came out to 2016, but that scene's just taken from Doctor Strange. Like, oh my god. And now let's get into Bailey, which not to confuse with Bailey from Hamster and Gretel. It's just Zack's love interest, I think. I haven't seen the show for years, so I need to rewatch the series. She's bland. Didn't really care for her in this movie. She was better than the TV show, but... Now, let's get into the worst scene of the movie. This movie, this scene, that made me just be done this movie. And that is the Get Zack and Cody scene. Honestly... This is the worst scene of the movie. Honestly, It's so annoying. This scene is like taken from a Spy Kids movie. And the basically the villain pressed the button and they used the laser thing and he just said to him, "Get Zack and Cody." And honestly, when I first saw that scene, I said, "Okay, that's it. I'm done with this movie." It just, I was completely heartbroken how bad this movie was. This is a, and then at the end, the villain got arrested. So it's the twist villain, which honestly, the twist villain, it looks like a, it just looks like taking the face off. It just looks like Clayface from Dark Knight. It kind of reminds me of just the twist, just kind of like, just oh God. At the end, the villains got arrested, and they're back together. And Zack's got the car at the end, but got destroyed. And that's how the movie ends. Honestly, guys, I'm actually heartbroken. And honestly, guys, speaking of Gat, Zack, and Cody, if I was in that movie, you know what I would do, guys, before I end this rant? You know what I would do if I was in the movie? I'll just go home and watch TV.
He's busted. Let's get him out of here.
We now join America's most popular show already in progress. Everybody loves Hypnotoad.
This show's been going downhill since season 3.
So yeah, that's how Roar of a dude that get chased by those kids. But overall, guys, this movie had a lot of potential. It had potential to be a great film. I want this. I actually want to like this movie. I want this movie to succeed. It was not a good movie. This is this is a slap in the face to the TV show, a slap in the face to both TV shows, and absolutely a disgrace to one of Disney Channel's most popular sitcoms. And this is how they repay me. But honestly, guys, I want to love this movie. I really want to like it. This had potential. And honestly, guys, I'm going to say this, guys. Thank God this movie never got a DVD release. That's right, guys. Thank God this movie never got a DVD release. Like Artemis Fowl. Like, that film was crap. That film never got a DVD release. Thank God this movie didn't get a DVD release. And honestly, guys, it didn't really feel like a movie. It feels like an extended long episode of the TV show. It feels like a fan fiction. The film is kind of mean spirit. It didn't really. It also feels like a Lab Rats episode than a Sweet Life movie. I can tell the people who never. I can tell the writers have never seen an episode of the TV show. Well, I don't know. It got a different cast, different director who has the first experience on this show, which I can give credit. At least he tried, but I can tell they have no end of source material of the series, but. Honestly, guys, I mean, they got the wrong director. The direction they took was the wrong direction, and this had potential to be a great, given the proper send off this series deserves. And honestly, guys, it just really breaks my heart. This movie was really broke my heart, guys. Like, I was actually really upset after I watched this movie. I got so upset, and this movie was so bad. It made me don't want to watch an episode of Sweet Life Zack and Cody ever again. After I watched a shitty film back in 2012 when it first came out, well, it came to my country in 2012, I didn't watch a single episode ever since. I was just like, no, I was heartbroken how bad this movie was. And after that, it just made me want to watch this show ever again. Because this movie deserved more. Honestly, I would rather watch High School Musical than over this. At least High School Musical, yeah, sure, that movie sucks. At least people don't talk about that movie anymore in 2011 onwards. Well, 2010, actually, technically. So, but honestly, guys, I mean, they got the wrong director, the wrong writers. It had potential to be a great send-off to the series. It deserves. And honestly, it wasn't a good film at all. On rewatch, it got worse. And worse and worse the more I think of it. I thought the trailers were good, but the actual film was a piece of shit. I didn't know this movie would be terrible until when I watched it. And funny enough, guys, this movie got a 50 something on Rotten Tomatoes. Critics didn't like the movie. It got 5.1 on IMDb. Pretty much the critics and fans did not like this movie. As a longtime fan, I hate this movie with a passion. It just really breaks my heart. I mean, so overall, guys, I want to love this movie, but honestly, it wasn't a good film. I suggest just stick to the TV shows. The Sweet Like Zack and Cody is a much better series, much better show compared to this movie. Just watch that, watch Sweet Light on Deck, and that's it. Those two were much are more worth watching than this movie. And I wouldn't call this movie canon to the series. So, and I remember what back in years ago, this movie was about to turn on, about to be on. And guess why, guys? They're about to air it about 2012, 2030. And guess why they were? Guess why, guys? I actually switched the channel to Disney XD to watch Fierce of Verb instead. Yeah. I gave this movie a 0 out of 10. It just wasn't a good film at all, guys. I'm actually sad this movie was not good at all. I mean, coming to a longtime fan of the series, but since I mean, I loved the series growing up. These two actors are like the most recognizable Disney Channel actors of all time. And this is what put Disney Channel on the map. They're like, this is when, back when it was a great channel. It still was a great channel, even though that channel's no more in my country. That channel got closed down in my country back in 2020. Anyway, guys, I'm going to hit, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel, like and share your friends, and stay tuned for my rant on Madam Web. Bye!
Chirp.